Alerts and sheets don't get along in SwiftUI. In this video, I'm diving into the common headache of getting alerts and sheets to play nice in SwiftUI. I'll break down why these two can be a pain to work with together and share some tips and tricks I've picked up along the way to work with them smoothly. With easy to follow explanations and real world examples, I'll help you navigate through this tricky part of SwiftUI development. Join me and let's figure out this together. And don't forget, I have the keys for you to escape tutorial hell. Go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring where you can meet me face-to-face, one-on-one Zoom call. Go ahead and check it out, rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now today, we are going to kind of have an extra tutorial on the tutorial about mastering SwiftUI alerts, simplifying implementation with a better approach. It was well received, and I had a comment over here, which kind of addressed sheets. So it says, Mr. Lowright, this is wonderful, but it doesn't work with sheets. Is there an easy way to get this to work with sheets? Yes, we are going to do that today. Thank you for the observation and basically the bug report. I have already added the fix into the SwiftUI alerts repository, so you can use it straight away and you can take a look at the code. But today we are going to build it out. So let me just go ahead and open up the Xcode project. A link to the previous video will be in the description, so go ahead and then maybe check that out first. But let me just build and run so you can see what we have currently. So it's an alert, and it just pops up a confirmation dialog, which can confirm, no, cancel. We can use this for alerts too. You know, this is just the buttons alert. It could be confirmation dialog. You know, you can just set over here. Alert controller will present alert or confirmation dialog with a title and a message and these buttons. So it's really, really powerful. It is basically imperative way of creating alerts. But here's the problem that let me just double check on the name, Mr. Lowright said. So here's the example. And by the way, check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. Okay, so here's what the problem with this might be. Let's just create a sheet right over here. So I'm going to create a struct, and let's just have this name this as sheet view. It will be of type view. And let's move all of this button into the sheet view. Okay, so now we are going to present this sheet in this button. So instead of alert, we're going to say sheet. And I'm just going to say alert right over here. So it will be actual alert right over here. So we are going to present a sheet. So sheet view, that's with the W. Let's just have this is sheet presented right over here. I already added that. And then we can just say is sheet presented dot toggle. So we are presenting that sheet. And here it is, sheet. With is presented, let's just say $ is sheet presented, and the content will be our sheet view. Okay, so now because you have already set up uses alert controller, you might expect that this should work. You know, we're just moving into another sheet. By the way, this works seamlessly when you are going to the navigation link. But here's our problem. So first of all, we have this alert controller issue, but maybe I'm just going to have and add that environment right over there. Of course, we could have added it right over here, but you know, just moving into another sheet. So let's just build and run and see what the problem here is. Are you an aspiring iOS developer? Collaborate with me as your mentor at rebeloper.com/mentoring to accelerate your career. Leveraging my extensive industry experience and in-depth knowledge of iOS development, I provide practical insights, the latest industry trends, app-efficient coding strategies to help you succeed. Let's take your iOS development to the next level. Join me at rebeloper.com/mentoring. We present the sheet and then the alert. So the sheet will be dismissed and then this alert will be popped. So that's not right. Of course, we want this alert to be presented on the sheet itself. So this is the issue that we are having right over here. So let's confirm that. And let me just show that to you again. So that's not the way to do it. This is really, really bad. So what is the actual solution for here? Well, the quick and easy solution is to have a dot uses alert controller added to the sheet view, you know, the contents of the sheet view modifier. Let's build and run, and let's see that now. Let's present the sheet, click on the alert. There we have it. We have, and we can just confirm that. It says confirmed. Maybe we can just say nope. It says nope. And we can also cancel out of that. And also, we can slide it down. It will work exactly as we would expect it. Okay, that's fine. This is great. But I would like this to be a little bit more convenient for us to use. Maybe I will forget to add uses alert controller. Therefore, I just want to create a simple view modifier. I'm going to go to the extensions and create a function called sheet with alert. Okay, this will actually return some view, and I'm going to add in here self.sheet, and one with the is presented on this missing content. Let's just do that one, and then we want to add in here some properties. So for the is presented, we want to add a binding. So that is presented binding of a bool. Okay, then we are going with the on dismiss. That will be an optional completion, nil is its default value, and a completion goes like this, void. Okay, and finally, we want to add the content. So content, actually it's a view builder, so we want to add at view builder content. At escaping, and then we are going to have a content. Now the content has to be declared. It will be of type content, type view. Okay, so now we can just add all of these in here. So is presented on dismiss. And then for the content, I'm not just going to pass it along. I'm just going to say content, two parentheses, and then uses alert controller. So I don't have to worry about it. So now let's come back to our content view. And then instead of this implementation, let me just comment that out and add dot sheet. And now we have this one with the alert, a sheet with alert. I'm going to use the first one and say $ is sheet presented. And then the content is the sheet view. Now let's see if that actually worked. Build has succeeded. Let's present our sheet and then the alert. Exactly the same. Really, really nice. We can slide it down, show it again. Alert. Nope. Fine. It works exactly as we want it to. Now, there's another view modifier that I would like to tackle right over here, and that is the one with the sheet and the item. So let's have a function called sheet with alert. And let me just have some view over here. And this time we're going to go self.sheet, and we're going to choose the one with the item and on dismiss and content. So the item, as you can see, it's a binding of identifiable. So let's start typing the item, and you are going to have a binding. But of course, you can have identifiable, that's a protocol. So we want to have set up an actual item which is identifiable, and then I'm just going to add that as an optional. So item optional. Okay, and the same goes for everything else. So I'm just going to copy that out and paste it in there. Oh, by the way, let me just have these in new lines so we can read it a little bit better. Great, and also for the item on dismiss and view builder. And we are also going to need a content right over here. Content, content of type view. There we go. Maybe this will make a little bit more sense so we can read it a little bit better. Okay, so now we just bind the content. So we bind the item and then on dismiss. And then for the content, we are going to get back an item, which is of course an identifiable. But now we want to move it back. You know, we need to have it inside that completion that we are going to use. How to do that? Well, we need to add the item to this completion right over here. So we are going to say content, open parentheses, we pass along the item, and then dot uses alert controller. This is how you want to do that. Of course, I don't have an example set up for this project, but go ahead and check it out. But of course, you want to use all of this for full screen covers too. So let me just copy and paste these two and say this is a full screen cover. I'm going to copy out full screen cover and just paste it or wherever it's needed, right over there. And it's as easy as that. Now, this has been added already into the SwiftUI Alerts GitHub repository. Go ahead and check it out. It's called the model support. And if you like to learn more about SwiftUI or Swift in general, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring.